Okay, the first thing I'm going to do is I've turned the pallet over with the stringer side up. I think that's what you call these horizontal supports. And I'm going to take one of them on the end off. And I bought a little handy dandy tool to do that. It's a leverage tool. It was from Amazon. I think it was about $65, something like that. It's very heavy. Some people take these apart with everything from a maul and a piece of wood to jumping on it to using a sawzall or a reciprocating saw and just sawing them apart. There's all different ways of taking pallets apart. I'm going to pry it apart. And you can use a crowbar, but I found this is really a nice tool to use, especially with these heavy-duty pallets. And what I'm going to do, and do it one-handed, I'm going to slide this right up under, and then go like, I can do it one-handed, sure I can. Alright, that's it, there we go. And as I bring the handle down, it brings the supports up, and of course I've got a step on it, so it doesn't go anywhere. But just pry it up. Hopefully I won't have helpers. I let the goats out to graze and they're hanging around. Lena, why aren't you doing schoolwork?
Because I don't have school to do it. Because I don't have anymore to do.
Okay. And
the dishwasher is
heavy. Okay, that was my next question. Alright. And I just go along each section. I'm pushing down obviously with one hand because I got the other one with the camera.
Okay.
Oh, good. You want to try?
Sure.
All right, you try, and then I can. You know?
I don't let Gracie play with myself.
Yeah. Just that's good. Now just move it down to this one.
Down to
this one right here. Yep. Get it right up. Nope. Get it right up against. There you go. There. And then I just go back through one more time. So easy. Even a little wimpy 13-year-old
hey!
Can do it. Okay, you put, yeah. Okay, she's never used this before, so this is pretty good.
Yeah, I'm gonna let you do it.
What you want to do is get it really close, I found. And then, it'll start evening out. That's pretty good. I probably can get it right off. And it's easier when you, yep. There you go. Don't step on those nails. That's the only thing you got to watch out for when you're taking these pallets apart. Yep, good. Just kind of wiggle it off. There you go.
Uh-huh.
Don't step on the nail.
I won't.
All right, now, let me just set that off to the side. And set this off to the side too, if you don't mind. Now I've got three nails in each section that I have to pound out. So I'm going to lift this up and put it on my little workbench. Okay, now if you don't have a handy-dandy manure spreader workbench, I'm sure a couple of saw horses and a 4x8 piece of plywood would do. But I don't want to make you jealous, but yeah, because this is a really good workbench. Really? Out! Out, Haley! Out! Go on! Go on, go on, go on. Oh, God, we got critters everywhere. Anyway, now I'm going to pound my nails out. And I just pound them with a hammer down a little bit, and then I pull them out the other side. A lot of people will pound these right down to the wood. I have trouble getting them out if I try pounding them that far. I don't know why. So I'm just going to do that a little bit, and when I get them out, we'll come back. Something I forgot to mention. When you pull all the stringers off, and then you're going to pull all the nails out, you might want to sink some screws first, because if I take all these nails out of here, that board's going to be loose. And same here and same there. So what I'm going to do is sink my screws first, and then from this side, and then pull the nails out from the other side. And that will make it much easier to keep my pallet together while I'm working on it. So just had that thought here. Okay, the next step is I'm going to fill in these two gaps. Now, you wouldn't have to do this with planters because a lot of people line them with landscape fabric rather than fill that in, but I just think it looks nicer because these are going to be up by the house. Plus, it's just one, if the landscape fabric, which does have usually a 15-year warranty, but if it should leak, then I've got a backup plan. So I've split apart a different pallet and kept the boards, and I'm just going to measure these gaps and then cut the board accordingly. Usually they measure anywhere from 1 3/4 to 2 inches, and they do vary, so you have to measure each slat. Now this is a little different. I'm doing this one different than the one that I showed you that's all done, because I realized I don't have to fill in the slats all the way down, because I'm putting a false bottom in, so it's only to here that I'm going to have soil. And that just is going to make it less weighty if I don't fill in all the slats and less work for me. So that's how I'm doing this one, so they'll look a little different. But this measures about 1.5 inches, so I'm going to go up and rip that board and then come back and put it in. Okay, I've got the sides done, so you can see this is how they're going to be in the finished product. And this stringer right here, or support, or whatever you want to call it, is for the bottom base, or the false bottom. Now, a lot of people, when they build planters like this, or raised beds like this with the pallets, they don't pull off any stringers on the base, or on the false bottom. They leave the whole pallet together and lay it in there as is. And that's definitely faster. But when they do that, if you look at this, they're going to lose 6 inches of planting depth by putting this whole thing in. I'm going to take this off, and then I only lose 2 inches, because to me that makes the bed too shallow, and I want at least a foot of planting space. So I'm going to go ahead on this one and pull these three stringers, or whatever you call them, not sure, supports. I'm not sure what to call them. I'm going to pull those off, and then I'm going to fill in the slats like I did on the sides all the way across, and that'll be my base. And when I get that done, I will show you. Okay, I got one end done. I have to make another. And you do these end pieces just like the side pieces. Now, if you have a square pallet, and I don't even know if they make them square, but if you do, then you're not going to have overhang. It's going to fit nicely. And for these end pieces, you can't put them this way, you know, with the flush side out. You have to put them with the stringer side, or the support side, whatever those are called, outward, just so that it will be flush on the inside. Okay, of your box. But I don't mind that too much. And you could finish them off like this, as is, or, and this is what I'm going to do, I'm going to take the second support off, and then Tim said he would cut them, not in half, but right under this one right here. And then I'll just screw this little shortened piece onto there. Now, I could have deconstructed this and made it to fit nicely on the ends without the overhang, but frankly, that's too much work and too much time to put into these. So I'm just going to live with the overhang. You know, I don't think it looks that bad. And depth-wise, I think I have 11 inches in this bed. Yep. Well, yep, just 11. And that's not too bad for strawberries. So there you go. I'm going to get another end done and put it. And then the last thing we have to do is line it with landscaping fabric. I'm not going to put it together here, however. I'm going to take it in sections and put it where I want it, and then screw it together. And after I do that, then I can show you putting the weed barrier in it. So, almost done. Okay, here I've got them up front. They're by the strawberries. Ready to line them with my weed barrier cloth. And I can't decide which way I like them, whether I like them this direction or that direction, so I'm going to see what Tim says. And here's where I made the difference, or the change. That one I didn't fill in at the bottom, and the first one I made, I did. So I kind of like the looks of that, especially turned the other way, but we'll see what Tim says, and if he's got a better spot for these. I'm going to be filling them with the compost pile back there. That's what I did with these strawberries. These strawberries are now 3 years old, even though they're blossoming. They're out in the lawn and everything else. So this bed definitely needs to be gone over. The mother plant thrown away, and the babies replanted. And then some more of the runner babies will go in here. And so they'll be enough. They'll be sparse, but it'll be enough to do all three beds. So there's my strawberry beds. One project crossed off the list. I'd show you lining it with this, but quite frankly, I'm a little tired. I moved them up here with the four-wheeler, and putting them together, that was kind of a fiasco. I was propping them with everything I could put my hands on, like this. Anyway, got them together, and we'll see what Tim says about location and position. I think I'm going to go with the wide side towards the driveway. I don't know. And maybe later on when I get more time, I'll be a little creative and like paint something along there. I don't know. Right now, I can't think about it. But there you go, strawberry beds. And here's what I did with all the stringers or the supports or whatever you want to call them, the horizontal supports that were on here that I knocked off. I made myself a bench. So nothing goes to waste with these pallets.